Please stand for the arrival of the official party and remain standing for the national anthems. Please be seated. Ladies and gentlemen, this evening's program is titled Aroa Roa, Sorrow. From a population of just over 1 million, 42% of New Zealand men of military age enlisted. Ultimately, over 100,000 soldiers and nurses served with the New Zealand Expeditionary Force overseas in the Pacific, at Gallipoli, on the Western Front, and in Sinai, Palestine. The musical work that you are about to hear, Tarakihi, symbolizes this exodus of New Zealanders. The regimental colour of 4th Otago Southland Battalion, carried by 2-4 Battalion Royal New Zealand Infantry Regiment, and the regimental colour of 6th Hauraki Battalion, carried by 36 Battalion, Royal New Zealand Infantry Regiment, will be marched on during Tarakihi to acknowledge that the battle honours they carry were earned in defence of this land. As these regimental colours come into sight at either side of our memorial, at that point, would you please stand? Please be seated. A century after the First World War, it is difficult to comprehend the horror of trench warfare. A few short months after war began, all movement ground to a halt. Both sides settled into the Western Front. A system of trenches remained in place for almost the entire war. Over 40,000 kilometers of interlinking and opposing trenches ran from the Belgian coast to the Swiss border. Cold, wet, and surrounded by death from battle or disease, these trenches were an appalling place to live and to die. Trench warfare created a stalemate which turned the conflict into a horrific war of attrition. There were, however, occasional reprieves from the horror. The Christmas truces of 1914 and 1915 saw a series of unofficial ceasefires occur along the front. Soldiers mingled. They exchanged food and souvenirs. In New Zealand, their families gathered together to celebrate Christmas as best they could, but always knowing that their loved ones were in harm's way. These were torturous times for families back in New Zealand. News took months to travel around the globe to home. Families seldom knew how their loved ones were faring, and they consoled themselves praying for a safe return. Sergeant Major Duane Bloomfield's composition, Passchendaele, is a musical depiction of the events that unfolded that day. The six movements are titled Barrage, Reflection, Slaughter, Aftermath, Grief, and Requiem. The music opens in the trenches. Young soldiers in the half-light of early morning wait, while all around them the artillery barrage.
Thank you.
After the barrage, there is a brief moment of stillness. Soldiers have time for a final reflection on home before facing the uncut barbed wire of no man's land 27 meters in front of them. At the sound of the attack whistles, the New Zealand troops surged from the trenches into waist-deep mud. Caught on the barbed wire, they were cut to shreds by German machine gun fire. In 3 short hours, New Zealand sustained 2,735 casualties. More than 900 either dead or mortally wounded on the barbed wire, dying a slow, a painful, and a lonely death. The survivors, shocked by the atrocity, grieve for their comrades, while the final letters of the dead, written as they had waited for battle in the trenches, take their somber journey home to New Zealand.
Okay.
A solemn requiem to the dead honors their bravery and comradeship. The work concludes with the sound every New Zealand household dreaded during the First World War, the telegraph delivery boy knocking on the front door, bringing news of death. A sound heard nearly 2,000 times throughout New Zealand after the October 1917 Passchendaele battles. Thank you. On this day, 100 years ago, a solemn bond was forged in blood between New Zealand and Belgium, never to be forgotten.
Loving Father, you created us in such a way that we cannot love without feeling pain. We grieve for those for whom the telegraph boy visited, for those who endured the terror and hardship of war, for those who marched under our colours and won our battle honours, those families, and Ngā Hoia are part of us and we of them. As we pray for peace, we give you thanks for their sacrifice. Lord, may your Wairua Tapu well up within us to heal us, make us strong, and to hunger for peace, justice, and a better world. Forgive us, Lord, for when we have broken your peace. Lord, please make us the best peacemakers and peacekeepers in the world. Standing here, surrounded by a mighty cloud of witnesses, if it be our lot to face evil and injustice, please grant us the tenacity and strength of character that is worthy of their sacrifice. Help us to remember the cost of war, to work for a better tomorrow, and as we commend to you lives lost in terror and conflict, bring us all, in the end, to the peace of your presence. Dwelling here amongst the fallen, we have sensed the Ngā Rōia Mata Tōroa. So before you, and to the fallen we say, Ina mate, haere, haere, haere atura. To those who have passed on, bid farewell. I runa e te ingoa o te atua, te amatua, te atama, me te wairua tapu. Amen.
Please stand for the commemoration.
E kore rātou e kaumātua tia. Pēnei a tātou kua mahue nei. E kore hoki rātou e ngoi kore. Aha koa, pēhea I ngā āhuatanga o te wā. I te heke ngātua te rā, tai noa, ki te aranga mai I te ata. Ka maumahara tonu tātou ki a rātou. Ka maumahara tonu tātou ki a rātou.
They shall grow not old, as we that are left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn. The going down of the sun, and in the morning, we will remember them.
We will remember them.
Oh, Benjamin, Isaac, Tom, Passchendaele, Ypres, and Somme. Three ovals float on the cold wall, plastered whiter than their bones. Young, khakied, their bud-tender eyes premonition-filled. Ellen, her three boys gone, transplanted 70 years from Lurgan's linen, no longer counts crops in season, but digs diligently, delicately, digs down, further down, her spade searching her garden for three lost sons, Thomas, Isaac, and Ben.
Please be seated. The sunset ceremony will close with an iconic Maori love song composed in 1914 and sung by the 19th and the 20th Maori reinforcements serving as combat engineers here in 1917.
Yeah. From what,